Hello everyone and welcome to the Captain's videoweblog. We are Tuesday, March the 22nd, 2016, and boy, I just heard it when I went to sleep yesterday morning. Belgium's capital, Brussels, has been attacked not once but twice, and somehow I feel that it just cannot be, you know. It can be a coincidence, because on Friday, the guy who spearheaded the attacks in Paris last November was arrested, and on Tuesday this happens near the town where he was hiding. It just can be a coincidence, but you know, it must be. Well, you think that if you symbolically cut the head off, it will just stop? I don't think so. It's very ironic because, like, all through the weekend, French and Belgian authorities were being pretty self-congratulatory about how they arrested the man who was behind all the attacks, and like that. Oh, somehow it was all good again. No. I know that they didn't say that it was all good again, but you know, it really felt like, haha, we have finally made it. No, are you kidding me? This is the Islamic State is an organization who will probably need to be completely run into the ground, you know, to eliminate it to the last person to stop their activities, you know. It's just not by arresting one person that it's all gonna stop. And I think that, yeah, if anything, the attacks in Brussels have shown us that, and I mean in a even more real way. But then again, I think that, I mean, it's all the same discourse, because the organization, you know, ISIL, pretty much revendicated those attacks as soon as they happened, and once again everyone was doing, you know, the same old shit that happens since 9/11, I would say, and the same kind of reports suddenly emerge that, well, we knew that there was going to be an attack, but we didn't know when or where. I mean, that's a huge failure in terms of intelligence, you know, because if 9/11 has shown us anything, is that, well, I mean, if you have reports of people potentially dangerous being able to be provided with the means to their madness, it's gonna happen, and probably earlier than you think. For 9/11, it was like 2 weeks before that the terrorist entered the U.S. territory. For France, they've known it like for, I don't know if it was for November or for January, but they had known it since August of 2014. At one point, you have to really, and I know that it's complicated because there are so many potential targets, and by targets I mean on both sides, you know, on the side of the terrorists there are potentially an awful lot of sleeper cells, but there are also lots of places that could be targeted. And it's not possible to, you know, just put one person on everyone. But at one point, there's the need, you know, to do their job, basically. So anyway, back to something more lighthearted, I think, because we all need it. It's really weird because it's literally the moment I went to sleep, suddenly reports from everywhere, because I always browse the internet before going to sleep for some reason. So yeah, reports from everywhere saying that the airport in Brussels has been attacked, and I'm like, that's really terrible. That's a horrible event, you know. And then I wake up and people are suddenly trending on Twitter. People are talking about a metro station in Brussels, and I discovered that there was another attack. And I mean, that's tough, twice in the same day. It's like, hey, you think you stopped us? Well, we stepped it up. Yeah, back to something more lighthearted, I guess. I don't know how I could make the whole situation sound, you know, the whole thing not sound really awkward after the last, well, 5 or 6 minutes. But yeah, I really don't know. You know, if I had not talked about that, I could go on and talk normally, but that's gonna be tough. I could, you know, walk myself into a wall and start by saying that my application letter is literally not finished. I've written the same fucking sentence I write in every single of my application layers, which is, well, I'm studying in that place, and I'm making that year of that course, and I'm looking for an internship that's gonna last for 6 months for the end of my studies, and that has to start in the following, you know, in the next 10 days, basically. So, yeah. I haven't even written the subject, you know. I haven't written who I'm sending it to. I'm doing really, really my best, you could say. Yeah. Man, you know, I've been talking about how much the water in Montpellier was bad, but I mean, I've been feeling the effects of that for like, well, I mean, I've been home for a month and a half at this point, yeah, and it's just now started, and I mean, during this month and a half, I've put some cream on my hands every single day, and it's just now starting to be, well, not scaly anymore. And between my fingers, it's a whole other story, because I mean, it's kind of place where even if you were to treat it like crazy, you would have to stay with both your hands, all fingers stretched, you know, just to make it kind of effective. So that's gonna take a little more time, I guess. Yeah, I was going to say that, oh, my hands are so soft, and it's over, but I realized that on the sides of my hands, you know, the more fleshy parts, that's, you know, for some reason, they still are pretty, well, dry, if anything. I mean, I'm not talking about this on a purely self-absorbed way, but I know that if I ruin my hands, you know, at age 22, that's gonna be tough when, well, my body starts falling apart, which might be happening sooner than later, because of the way I live. What is there to talk about? I mean, right now I think it's almost 2 a.m. I've read a couple of things that make me really worried about, you know, the Batman versus Superman movie, which are reviews. Apparently, people have been on the Rotten Tomatoes page and have seen the score, the grade decrease point by point. It's like the Fine Brothers YouTube subscriber countdown at this point. I've heard that right now it's at 30% of approval. I don't know if how that really works. But yeah, it's only at 30%, which is terrible, which is pretty much abysmal for a superhero movie in the in this era, you know. But kind of reflects just how bad marketing has been. Like, everyone was advertising it at Batman versus Superman, and even now it's Batman versus Superman: Dawn of Justice, and suddenly in one trailer that was out like months ago, Batman, Superman, Wonder Woman, and the actual big bad. Yeah, way to sell us that movie, huh, Zack Snyder? Or whoever is doing those movies. Yeah. So anyway, yesterday's video was really weird. I tried to upload it, and usually when I upload it, I watch some videos, you know, just to pass some time. And it was really weird because I was watching the video, and suddenly I click on the video and my phone crashes, and I'm like, what the fuck? Has my phone been on for too long? And I didn't really watch what the video was. And then I watched the video, tried watching the same video a second time, and I think it's at that point that I kind of realized what the hell it was all about, because the thumbnail was pretty much, it was pictures repeating, but the way they were repeating clued me in on the fact that it was actually a 360, you know, cardboard video. I don't know how it's called. But yeah, I realized that on this new version of the YouTube app, well, that kind of videos make my phone crash. Thanks, Google. So yeah, it took me 3 times to actually realize it, and I thought that it was maybe a combination of that and the fact that my phone was also uploading a video, you know, so it was asking too much from my phone. So I did it without, you know, any video being uploaded, so earlier in the evening, and suddenly it crashed. So yeah, what is there to talk about, really? Nothing, I guess. Yeah. So anyway, thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. Don't do some shitty amalgams. Oh yeah, that's the kind of things that are, you know, it's always the same rhetoric, but I think that it's really necessary to say it, because, I mean, I've thought about it in a very humorous way, which is, the supporter of the Paris football team. Some supporters have been known to be really anti-Arabic. And, well, not only anti-Arabic, but also very xenophobic. Yeah. At the same time, they were the one who made the stadium of not being literally dead, you know? Even though some of the supporters died because of infighting and all that, but what can you do? It's Paris. And I was thinking, like, are some of those fans, are people who are saying, yeah, it's all the same, Muslim people, Arabic people, terrorists, and at the same time, they're like, yeah, thanks Qatar for investing in Paris, and I'm like, what the fuck kind of hypocrisy are you doing, you know? Or maybe they're blaming Qatar for making Paris so superior to every team in France that makes the league so weak in comparison to Paris, which is the reason why Paris can go that much further in European competitions. I don't know. So, yeah. Don't do shitty amalgams. Don't be a shitty person, please. Goodbye.